Blessed be the name of our God. We give God all the glory for the gift of a brand new day. A lot of people that went to bed last night, like me and like you, they went to bed with the hope of waking up this morning and going to work and doing one thing or the other. Unfortunately, it was their last day on earth. They have gone, they have died. But you went to bed and you wake up this morning and you see a brand new day. So we give thanks to God that you are here, I'm here. Glory to God. Glory to Jesus. Today is the day 11 of the fasting and prayer. And I'm here praying for you. And like I said, some people have already sent their prayer requests. If you have not sent yours, just drop a message. And we are here to pray for you. I'm just going to share a word before working from home today. So I want to share a word with you and just to encourage you to continue and to pray. You have a lot of prayer points there on the platform, and I want you to continue to pray. And remember that the reason for this fasting is for us to ask God to do a new thing in our lives, a new thing that God should put a song of joy in our lips. We've sang old song for so long that this year we have sung so much old songs, and like in Psalm 40, verse 1 to 3, right? We're asking God that it will take us from the miry clay, to set our feet on the rock, and it should put a new song in our mouth, on our lips. So from this half of the year, God is going to give us a new song. And that new song is what we are praying for. Protection for your family, your children. People that are looking for a job, they're going to have a job. After the 21 days fasting, you're going to have a job. Testimonies will abound. People that are waiting for God for one thing or the other, God is going to do it for you in Jesus' name. Amen. But if you don't join in the fasting, if you don't join in the prayers, or you don't join in the connect to the anointing, unfortunately, I'm not sure how you're going to get the blessings, because I'm already blessed. A lot of people are blessed. I don't know what you're waiting for. So this morning, I just want to share quickly and on the topic that says, turn your complaints into prayers and thanksgiving. Turn your complaint into prayers and thanksgiving. So I don't know what your complaints are. I don't know what you think that is not working right for you, and you've been worried about it, and you've been mourning and complaining about it. Today I've come to advise and I've come to encourage you that you turn your complaint into prayers. I'm going to be reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 10. So I'm going to be reading verse 1 to 11 very quickly. I'll try to read as quickly as possible. It says here, "For I do not want you to be ignorant of the fact, brothers and sisters, that our ancestors were all under the cloud and they all passed through the sea. They were all baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea. They all ate the same spiritual food and drank the same spiritual drink. For they drank from the spiritual rock that accompanied them, and that rock was Christ. Nevertheless, God was not pleased with most of them. Their bodies were scattered in the wilderness." Okay? "Now, these things occur as an example to keep us from setting our hearts on evil things as they did. Do not be idolaters, as some of them were, as it is written. The people sat down to eat and drink and got up to indulge in revelry. We should not commit sexual immorality as some of them did. And in one day, 23,000 of them died. 23,000 of them died in one day. We should not test Christ as some of them did and were killed by snakes. And do not grumble as some of them did and were killed by the destroying angel. These things happened to them as an example and were written down as warning for us, on whom the culmination of the ages has come. So if you think you are standing firm, be careful. I repeat, if you think you're standing firm, be careful that you don't fall. Praise be the name of the Lord. Yes. That Bible has told us, it's just taking us back to our ancestors, our forefathers, who were walking with Moses. These people saw the face of God. It goes with them like a pillar of cloud in the day by day, and goes with them as a pillar of fire by night. And God was with them. God gave them food. God gave them water. God gave them everything. And the rock that brought out water, the Bible said that rock was Jesus Christ himself. And they drank of the Lord Jesus Christ. And yet, you know, they still complain and they still mourn. And guess what happened? All the time, when God does something for them, they don't see any reason to give thanks to God. They don't see any reason to worship God. They worship him when he has done one thing for them. As soon as that thing God has done for them expires in their memory, they no longer go to God. They no longer praise the Lord. They no longer fast. They no longer pray. Some of us are like that. When we were poor, when we were in a state of poverty, when we were ill, when things were not going right with us, we were crying and begging God that God should visit us. God should do this for me. In fact, some of us even promised God, if you give me this job, if you give me this child, if you give me this degree, if you make me to go to my youth service and come back safely, you promise God that you're going to serve him. But as soon as you finish, you finish your youth service, you got the job you're looking for. And so some of you were praying for marriage, you got the marriage, you got the child. You have turned your back against God. You no longer pray. You no longer sing worship. You no longer sing praises to God. You no longer spend time in his presence. You are now criticizing churches. You don't attend service again. You no longer pay tithes. In those days when you were suffering, without your little meager money, you were paying tithes. You were paying offering in the church because you wanted God to touch you. And you think that you are deceiving God. The Bible says that God is not mocked. God is not mocked. Whatever a man soweth, he shall reap. Look at what our forefathers did. They eat and drink, and after they finished eating the food, some of them, they saw God gave them manna from heaven. They finished eating the food that God gave to them. The next thing is, they went and committed sexual immorality. They committed sexual immorality, homosexuality, lesbianism, sleeping with animals, adultery, all these things, the same thing that is happening now. That's what they did. And guess what the Bible says? In one day, 23,000 of them died. So when we see COVID, people are dying. I'm not judging that those people that are dying, they are sinners. But this could be also the hand of God. We don't know. We are human. We don't know. If God did punish sin, God punished our forefathers for committing sin. One day, 23,000 of them died. That is 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 6. They died. So how much more that God will not do it? After the Son, Jesus Christ, came and died, shed his blood, yet people still turn their back against him. Yet we still play pranks. And we start to say that going to church is not an act of worship. That worship lies in us. Of course, worshiping God lies in you. But the Bible also said that you should despise not the assembly of the brethren. A lot of us have grown over church. You know, we say, I've grown above sitting down and be hearing somebody preaching. I can read the Bible myself. I can pray by myself. That is the sign of a backslider. That's the sound of a backslider speaking. If you have grown to a level that you have grown over church, you no longer want to go to church, you don't want to sit under the anointing of any man, then that's a backsliding spirit speaking inside of you. So the same thing our forefathers did in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 6. they have eaten all the food God gave to them, but as soon as they finish, they go and commit sin, they go and complain, they moan as if they have never seen anything. So in one day, the Bible says in verse 8, that in one day, 20,000, 23,000 of them died in one day. So God still punished sin. So instead of you sitting down there and complaining and moaning and saying, God has not done this for me, for the fact that God has given you life and you can see today, that's enough miracle and for you to give God thanks. Because people that went to bed like me and you, they were moaning and they died in their sleep. But God kept you alive and brought you into a new day. It means there's a hope for you. Therefore, turn your mourning into prayers. Instead of you complaining, turn it into dancing. Turn it into testimony. That's what God wants from you. So the things that happened to them, our forefathers, those things that happened was for us as an example. And it was a warning for us so that we don't repeat the same thing. Unfortunately, we are still repeating the same thing they did over and over. We are still ungrateful to God. We are very ungrateful to God. For the gift of life, sometimes we just feel that, oh, I go to bed, I wake up. Go and put your lamb by a dead man. Go to the mortuary. In fact, pay a visit. You see the number of people lining up there. They are lining up there. There are about 50 or 60 or 100 of them in one room. They were like me and you. They have the air to breathe. They have the mouth to talk. They were all going about. In fact, some of them are professors, philosophers, doctors, nurses. They're all lying dead. And you are here, you have life, and you're complaining. Today, I encourage you that you turn your complaining, turn your murmuring and complaining into testimony. Turn it into prayers. Instead of you wasting time, say, God, today is another day. People have left the house. I don't have no job. And you're seeing that heaven and looking at me. Are you really God? Why is this happening to me? No. That's an attitude of a defeated foe. So you will lift up your voice and say, God, it's another day. Everybody have gone. I am here waiting for you to answer my prayer. God, thank you because I know my job is coming. Thank you because I know definitely very soon I'll be going out with them as well. Thank you because I know the work you're preparing for me is a greater package than the one I've had before. That is why I'm giving you thanks. I thank you for that job. Thank you for connecting me to where you want me to be. Thank you for connecting me to my destiny helper. Thank you, Jesus, for taking me to where you want me to be. That's your attitude. You haven't seen the job. Begin to thank God for the appointment paper. Thank you for that appointment paper. Thank you for that promotion. Father, I am not pregnant. Yes, I know. I know I'm not pregnant. Yes, I don't have a baby. I've been married for 5 years, for 6 years. But I come to thank you because it is you that made me who I am. And you have my destiny in your hand. And you said to Jeremiah, you know him before he was born. That is why in my condition like this, I'm still glorifying you because it is to your own glory that I don't have children. It is for your own glory that I can't have a baby. To your own glory, and I'm waiting for you like Elizabeth. I'm waiting for you like Sarah. I'm waiting for you, God, to visit me. That should be your attitude. It's not crying. No. It's not mourning. Somebody's mocking you. Say, Father, they're mocking you. They're not mocking me. When you say those things, you're moving the hand of God. Don't be like our forefathers who are so ungrateful. So that's what I come to tell you. Turn your complaint into prayers and thanksgiving. And turn your complaint into a laughter. Today is the 11th day of the fasting. If you have not fasted, join with me. Because God is doing great and mighty things. And don't be left out. Thank you. And have a wonderful day in His presence. Please use the prayer point on the platform. And continue to pray, and God bless you. Amen. Bye.